Hi everyone. In my last video, I was talking about what is mainframe and what are the different companies manufacture the mainframe systems, what are the futures of mainframes, and what is the operating systems installed onto the mainframe computer, and where the mainframe applications are used. In this video, I would like to discuss technically on the mainframe applications. As I told, I would be talking about more technically from now onwards. So what do you see? Let's go ahead and start with our technical points on mainframe. So I hope now you might be aware of what is a mainframe. So let's go and start with the mainframe. Mainframe applications are divided into two types. The first one is batch processing and online processing. So what exactly the batch process stands for? Batch is like single task environment where only one task can be executed. That means resources are allocated to one particular programs. It is simple. See, for example, it can execute only one task at a time. That means, for example, I'm listening and music. That's it. While listening and music, I cannot do any other activities like opening a Word doc or opening an Internet Explorer. Those all are multiple tasks, but during batch process we can do only one task at a time. Okay, in the same way in real time, in when I talk to the mainframe subject, it is a single task environment where only one task can be executed. That is, resources are allocated to one particular program. What is mean by resources? Resources means memory, CPU time, okay, space. This all comes into the picture. Okay, we will be going into more details. What exactly? How the memory is allocated? How the jobs are executed? How the program will be called? Or how the task will be running? Okay. Let's go ahead with the subject. In batch processes, series of programs are executed in sequential order. Once one task is completed, then only the next task can be started. Example, in batch process, generates reports like accounts, monthly statements, credit start statements, and salary pay slips. Okay. What happens here is, if you go into your bank, you might be depositing money daily. Okay, so one day you have deposited $100 or rupees, whatever it is. So another day you are deposited $1,000, $200, whatever. So at the end of the month, you wanted a statement. So as we talked in our earlier video, mainframe is mainly used for large volume of data. Who will be using this? Banking systems, insurance systems, so account monthly statements. So what you will do is, every day data is stored into your database, whatever the transactions you do. At the end of the month, it calculates, it fetches the data from the database and do the calculations and generates the statements. So in this batch process, so set of jobs are run and it creates the statements. That's simple. It is suited to handle large volume of data. It doesn't generate any instant results. and users have to wait of the output, right? That was about introduction to batch process. Let's come and discuss about the online process. It is a multitask environment. It is where multiple tasks can be executed concurrently. This is an opposite to batch process, whereas in batch it can execute only one task at a time, whereas in online it can execute multitask at a time. That is, resources are allocated to multiple programs concurrently. For online processor or ATM, yeah, this is the best example for the online process. See, we have multiple ATMs for a single banks, where a different users can go and withdraw their money through an ATM machines, right? This is the best example. Online process best suitable to handle low volume of data, right? Analog process will generate instant or immediate results. Yes, I have gone to ATM, I have withdrawn my amount and I get a statement, so and so money has been withdrawn, your balance remaining so and so and from which area. That's it, it's simple. So that was about the what is batch processing and online process. In the same way, we have types of programs. There are two types of programs: batch program, online program. Coming to the batch program, so we are going more technically now. So in batch program, you will have COBOL, COBOL plus DB2, COBOL plus VXAM, COBOL plus DB2 plus VXAM. These are different kinds of programming we do. So first one is like COBOL. What is a COBOL? COBOL is a, for now you can I will tell you, COBOL is a programming language. So here COBOL plus DB2. What is DB2? It is a database. It is a database where we store the data. So in order to retrieve the database, we need some language, that is COBOL. A COBOL plus DB2 is one kind of application programming. COBOL plus VXAM, this is also one kind of application programming. VXAM is also a database. This is a flat, this is non-flat database. COBOL plus DB2 plus VXAM, we can write also with this. So these all are different batch programs. In the same way, for online program, we have COBOL plus CICS, COBOL DB2 plus CICS, COBOL VXAM plus CICS, and again COBOL DB2 VXAM CICS. What it is varying here? CICS is coming into the picture. Okay, so that was about batch programming and online programming. So in the same way, after coding, after doing and programming on through COBOL and accessing through DB2 and creating a flat files or non-flat files with these both two databases, DB2 and VXAM are called databases. So we might, in after doing and coding and everything, we might get changes to it. Okay, in order to do changes to a programs or a jobs, we need to have some tool. So we have various version control tools used in real-time environment. That means mainframe suitable tools. Okay, so most of the companies use as Librarian, Changeman, Endeavor, Penvalent. So you might have Info. We have various version tools, depends upon the requirement or depends upon the company, they go for these tools. And in the same way, we have debugging tools. Debugger means testing of programs. So they have XP Editor and Intertest. Intertest will be having for both batch and online. These are the various debugging tools used. So that was about the introduction on the technical part. So we have talked about what is batch processing, online processing and various types of programs, how the applications are built. The applications can be built by go batch process or online process. When we go with batch process, it's with COBOL, normal COBOL plus DB2, COBOL plus VXAM, COBOL VXAM DB2. In normal process, COBOL CICS, COBOL DB2 CICS, COBOL VXAM CICS, COBOL VXAM DB2 CICS. We have various version control tools used in our real-time environment, library enrichment, and debug invalid. And also same way we have debugging tools, XPeditor and Interest. So let's go ahead and start with COBOL. What is a COBOL? As I told you earlier, COBOL is a programming language. The abbreviation is like Common Business Oriented Language. It is a very old language. I hope it was something started in 19th centuries. So it is a structural language. DB2 database, VXAM virtual storage access methods, CICS. CICS stands for Customer Information Control System. It is a command level language. JCL, job control language. JCL is used for compile both batch and online programs. JCL is used to only execute batch programs. CICS is used to execute only online programs. Okay, let's go into details of COBOL. What is COBOL? COBOL is a common business oriented language which is mainly developed for business applications. What are the various business applications? Banking application, insurance applications, telecom communication, real estate, manufacturing companies, reservation systems. These are the various different business applications. So COBOL is very vastly used for this application. Wherever we have mainframe, there we have COBOL. What are the features of COBOL? Features of COBOL is a structure pro it is a structured programming. It is very much easy to understand, easy to maintain, very high computing speed, better understanding of application programs, more readability of application programs. We have two types of COBOLs. There are PC-based COBOL and real mainframe COBOL. PC-based COBOLs are Micro Focus and Microsoft COBOL. Real mainframe COBOLs are VS COBOL, that is Visualize COBOL. These are the two types of COBOLs. Mainly we use real mainframe COBOL, that is COBOL VS COBOL, that is Visualize COBOL. So coming into more technical, COBOL language is used to build programs. So any program, COBOL language is used to build program. So in any programming language that has to follow some certain standards or certain structure. In the same way, to code a COBOL programs, we have a standard structure for it. So any program is mainly divided into four division, which are identification division, environment division, data division, procedure division. Then every division is further divided into sections, then sections to paragraphs, paragraphs to sentences, and sentences to statements. It is so simple. It is simple like a English language. When you further go on to more technically about coding of a COBOL programs, it will be very simple. It is same like learning an English language. In English, what we do, first we learn alphabets, then alphabets to words, words to sentences, sentences to paragraphs, paragraph to section. So that we follow the same structure here, divided every division are divided into sections, sections to paragraph, paragraph to sentence, and sentences to statements. Hi, hello everyone. Thank you for watching this video. I would be coming up with the more videos about technically about all different processes. I would discuss about more details about what is COBOL, what is DB2, VXAM, CICS, JCL. So it is very much useful. So once again, thank you for everyone for watching this video. Have a good day.